better. So instead of, if he's strong, I try to lift him into the air, raise his hand to the air, it stops at the shoulder. But if I leave that there and drop the elbow slightly, I've already started this action off here. And this can come a lot easier now. So if I try to take my hand to my head using my biceps, it's very difficult. He's pulling down all the time. But if he's strong there, he's got to be weak somewhere. So what I've done is I've dropped my elbow and I've got him to there. I might as well just take my head to my hand. It's easier than taking my hand to my head. So if I want to do that, I can make better technique anyway, couldn't I? I just take my head to my hand. Strong. It's logical, isn't it? Strong. Stronger than all that. But meet me halfway. So I want to get you. I want to do, this is what I like to do. Relax. That would be great if I could do that. That involves a big circle and the shoulder muscle. It stops, if he stops, he's strong here. Can't even start the movement here. But if I move to here, I've already interfered with his balance. And if I move across here, I interfere with his balance even more. If I turn to here, I can move to the elbow very easily. And that's logical as well, isn't it? So strong. Turn the way you wouldn't expect him to go. Because actually, release, relax. I want to go that way to get to there. This is where I'm going to end up. If I go this way first, symmetry here, yeah. There, there, go to the symmetry, yeah. This leg, down. So that's caused him to. More. So you tell me, allow me the chance to do that. So I've got strong flexion, displacement, tell me. Technique. Nikyo attacking the center is quite subtle. For instance, if I make Ayami, and I don't go over the top, but just strong grip, just alter here so slightly, and then turn the hand under, and then start attacking the forearm. That's the cue. Attack the center line. Here, here, here. And I haven't gripped anything. So I've gone this way. I'm relying on his grip, strong grip, which stays throughout. There's the balance loss, there's the turn. Strong grip, there. Balance loss, watch, there. So that feeling there is equivalent to that feeling. It's just the grip is different. Grip is on the side look. Turn. Good there. So if I do this, so I've got two nickels on. One. Two. On the side. Top side. That is similar to that feeling. Watch what happens to him when this hand goes this way, watch. It's just turned, and it's pushed in, into it. So, grip. So from this grip, and this grip is wrong, alter his balance ever so slightly. Turn the hand and put. Rather than shoulder turning, elbow turning out. Elbow turning outside, elbow turning underside. Gives you different formats to turn. But it's good. It's good. So this is if you just push it over. But you still need to make a technique. So this is the half of my technique for me. It's God took his body to that position. Took his body right to that position on that rotation there. Keep your shoulders low. Yeah. Pick it up. And carry on. See, just finishing the circle up. Don't be tempted to bring your forearm into it, which I like, use all I can do when you cut the forearm. It's okay, nothing wrong with that, but just for this, turn. Good. And then you can build it up and put a little bit of movement into it. Two. Two. Good. This side. Two. Two. This side. Three.